Voyager 1 is now over 24 billion kilometers from Earth. That's just under 15 billion miles, the farthest any human-made object has ever traveled. Despite being launched over 45 years ago, it's still sending data back home. But what if it turns its cameras back on today? Could it still capture anything in the vast emptiness of space? Now let's explore what Voyager 1 can truly see from the edge of the solar system. Launched on September 5th, 1977, Voyager 1's mission was to explore the outer planets of our solar system. At first, it was tasked with a grand tour of Jupiter and Saturn, providing us with breathtaking images and data that revolutionized our understanding of these gas giants. But its mission didn't stop there. After completing its planetary flybys, Voyager 1 continued on its path, venturing farther and farther from Earth. Today, it's not just the most distant human-made object, it's the first to cross into interstellar space. This journey, spanning over four decades, has taken it beyond the boundaries of the solar system into the unknown. But what can it see from that distance? Voyager 1 has a very unique place in history. It's the spacecraft that took one of the most famous photos of Earth ever captured, the pale blue dot. This image, taken in 1990 from a distance of about 6 billion kilometers, shows Earth as a tiny speck, less than a pixel in size, in the vastness of space. It's a humbling and awe-inspiring reminder of how small we are in the grand cosmos. But just 34 minutes after that iconic photo was taken, the camera on Voyager 1 turned off forever. The mission team decided to conserve power for the spacecraft's other instruments, essential for detecting interstellar plasma as Voyager 1 approached the outer limits of the solar system. This decision was practical, but it also meant that Voyager 1 became, quite literally, blind. But why turn off the cameras? After all, we're talking about a spacecraft with two onboard cameras capable of capturing the beauty of planets and distant stars. The answer lies in Voyager's dwindling power supply. Voyager 1 is powered by radioisotope thermoelectric generator, RTG. Whew, try saying that three times fast. Which converts the heat from the decay of radioactive materials into electricity. However, as time passes, the power output decreases. Every year, Voyager's power supply loses about 4 watts of energy. By the time it took that last iconic photo, the engineers knew they had to make a tough choice. Turning off the cameras was a way of extending the spacecraft's life, allowing the other specific instruments to continue collecting valuable data for years to come. The spacecraft's primary mission had shifted from visual observation to studying the space environment beyond the solar system, places where cameras wouldn't be as useful as other sensors. The camera itself required over 40 watts of power, a hefty demand when trying to stretch every bit of energy to last through the long, cold journey into interstellar space. The team even deleted the software used to operate the camera to free up memory for other crucial systems. With all these measures, they ensured that Voyager could continue its mission of exploration even without its cameras. It's been over 30 years since Voyager 1's cameras were switched off, and you may wonder, what would happen if we turned them back on today? Could they still capture anything meaningful? Or would the view be a black void of nothingness? First, let's consider the conditions. Voyager 1 is now 24 billion kilometers from Earth. That's a distance so vast, it's impossible to comprehend. Despite being so far from the sun, the light out there isn't as dim as you might think. In fact, the sunlight reaching Voyager is still 16 times brighter than a full moon as seen from Earth. So, if you were floating alongside Voyager 1, you'd have enough light to read a book. However, there's a catch. While there's light, there's not much to see. Voyager 1 is in a region of space where the objects around it, like planets or moons, are simply too small or too distant to be visible. If the cameras were turned back on, they would likely capture a dark, empty sky with only the faint glow of the sun and maybe a few distant planets reduced to tiny dots. This raises another interesting point. Despite traveling billions of kilometers away, the star constellations Voyager 1 would see are almost identical to what we see from Earth. You might think that traveling such a vast distance would give Voyager a new perspective on the stars, but it turns out that 24 billion kilometers, as mind-boggling as that sounds, is just a tiny fraction of the distance needed to shift our view of the constellations. For that, Voyager would have to travel thousands of light years. Let's take a step back and talk about the cameras themselves. Voyager 1 was equipped with two Vidicon cameras, one with a wide-angle lens and another with a narrow-angle lens. These were essentially early television cameras capable of capturing 800 by 800 pixel images in grayscale. But how did they produce those stunning color images of the planets? The magic came from a filter system. Voyager 1 would take multiple grayscale images through different colored filters, violet, blue, green, and orange. When these images were transmitted back to Earth, scientists would combine them, saturating each with its respective color to create the full color images we've come to know and love. This system worked beautifully for the planets it encountered: Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, each providing breathtaking views of their atmospheres, rings, and moons. But it also served to capture the historic pale blue dot image of Earth. However, transmitting these images from billions of kilometers away was no easy task. When Voyager 1 was much closer to Earth, it could send data at a rate of 115,000 bits per second. But now, as it drifts farther and farther away, the data rate has slowed to just 160 bits per second. To put that in perspective, transmitting a single image today would take over 8 hours, and the signal itself would take 21 hours to travel back to Earth. You might be wondering, could we even turn the cameras back on today? After all, they've been sitting unused for 3 decades, exposed to the harsh environments of space. The truth is, it's unlikely they would still function. Space is unforgiving, with extreme temperatures, radiation, and micrometeoroids constantly bombarding the spacecraft. Over time, the camera lenses and electronics have likely degraded, making it improbable that they could capture images today. Even if we could power up the cameras, the software and hardware on Earth needed to process those images no longer exist. The computers used in the 1970s to analyze the data have long since been replaced with more modern technology. Recreating the necessary systems to process the images would be a huge challenge. While the cameras might be out of commission, Voyager 1's other instruments are still going strong. It's continuing to send back valuable data from the edge of the solar system and beyond. In 2012, Voyager 1 made history again when it became the first spacecraft to enter interstellar space. It's now detecting the plasma waves of interstellar space, helping scientists understand more about the mysterious region beyond the influence of our sun. It's also studying cosmic rays, magnetic fields, and interstellar winds, things that are impossible to measure from Earth or even within the solar system. This data is crucial for understanding what lies beyond our cosmic neighborhood and how the sun interacts with the rest of the galaxy. The spacecraft is expected to continue operating until around 2025, when its power supply will finally run out. At that point, Voyager 1 will go silent, leaving us with decades of groundbreaking discoveries and a legacy that will last for generations. While Voyager 1's camera may be turned off, its mission is far from over. It continues to send back data that's helping scientists learn about the outer edges of our solar system and beyond. Even though it's far from home, Voyager 1 remains one of the greatest achievements of human engineering. Think about that. A spacecraft built in the 1970s, using technology that's now considered ancient, is still functioning, still communicating, and still making discoveries in 2024. It's a testament to the ingenuity of the scientists and engineers who designed it. Voyager 1 carries a message, too. On board is the Golden Record, a time capsule of Earth's sound, music, and greetings in 55 different languages. It's a message to any extraterrestrial life that may one day find the spacecraft, telling the story of who we are and where we came from.